there, it's Marlene Hillema from ImageMaven.com. And today's video tutorial is all about the high pass sharpening filter. And you would use this type of sharpening if you had a really blurry image. So it's a way to save a blurry image. This method works in Photoshop Elements as well as Photoshop, but I'm going to show it in Photoshop Elements, but it works exactly the same way. So let's open an image. So here's my image open in Photoshop Elements. The first thing I'm going to do is duplicate the background layer. I usually do that using a key command of Command J on the Mac and Control J on the PC. So you can see that we now have a layer one that is identical to the background. Next, you're going to go under the Filter menu and you're going to go all the way down to Other, and then you're going to choose High Pass. If you've never used this filter before, I think the default is like 10 pixels, which is way too high. What I suggest you do is bring the radius all the way down to the left, so the whole filter turns gray. And what you want to do then is slowly move it up until you start to see the edges of your image. Now, I'm going to back up a little, maybe to 1.5 pixels. And then when you're happy with that, go OK. And you can experiment with what works best for your particular image. If the image is super soft, you might want to raise that up. Now, after that, I go to my blending modes here and I choose Hard Light. Okay, so when I choose Hard Light, it blends these two layers together. Now I'm going to zoom in. And now I am going to compare what we started with, which is our background, and our high pass filter. So I'm going to uncheck it. And you can see that, hopefully on the video, you can see that it's softer, especially in her face here. And again, I'll apply the high pass filter, and you can see that it sharpens up. Now, if you went too far or you think you have too much sharpening, you can actually lower the opacity of that layer so you can take some of the edge off. But I'll just keep it at 100% in this case. If you decide that you only wanted to sharpen part of the image, what you can do is add a layer mask. And in this case, I'm going to add a black layer mask. So I'm going to hold down the Option key. And now I have a layer mask on my sharpened filter. So what that does is, remember, black hides or blocks the effect of that layer. So I'm going to paint now with a white brush. So I'm going to just turn my colors around. I'm going to go into my brush tool. And I can just hit the B for that. And I'm going to choose a brush. And in this case, that brush is a little small, so I'm going to make a larger brush. And now when I paint with my white brush on my mask, remember, I'm painting on my mask, it will only sharpen the parts that I've painted over. So let's zoom in again. So wherever I'm painting, that's the only place that that filter would be applied, because it's blocked in the rest of the image by the mask. Now, you don't have to necessarily use a mask. This is totally optional, especially if you wanted to selectively high pass sharpen certain areas. But if your whole image is soft, you can apply it to the whole image. Now, just to add a little variation, let's see what happens when we set the high pass filter at a really high value. So go under Filter, Other, High Pass. Last time we used 1.5 pixels. Let's juice it up to 10, just for fun. Actually, let's juice it up even more. Let's juice it up to 20, or close enough. Okay, so now our high pass filter is super high, and you can start to see some of the original image coming through. But we still have to change it to Hard Light. And when you change it to Hard Light, you can start to see, I'll just zoom in here, that it kind of has a surrealistic effect. It kind of looks like there's halos everywhere. And that's kind of what HDR styled photos look like. So in this case, it's much different than the last version, which was very subtle. You can see that there's some glowing on her face. Okay, but again, you can mask it out, or you can lower the opacity of the effect of that filter. I find that it tends to change the color a little bit too, so you've got to be quite careful with that high pass filter. So you can have it subtle, or you can have it severe. The choice is yours. It's a creative choice, and there's no right answer. So have fun playing with the high pass filter. If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, now's your chance to do so. Give me a thumbs up and leave me a comment or a question if you have one. Take care and thanks for watching. It's Marlene from imagemaven.com.